Welcome back. So that is a thing which is actually revolving around the world. So that is a thing called microservices, which is actually revolving around the world for the first 5-6 years, and so which actually reaches its mature stage. So it's good now. So that is another thing which gonna comes up in near future, which is called micro frontend. So from my side, I want to give some idea what is actually micro frontend. So what's from my understanding? So what I have a website. So I have a page where I actually, you know, if you are seeing right, blue dotted line, which is a React application. And this again is blue dotted line is a React application. And this is a view. So I'm the view render download. So this is view application. Suppose I ingest a value. We could see, right, if I change the value 6 years, it is 10 times greater than this Kong. So I'm the Kong, I'm 10 times greater, 10 times the King. So I'm communicating from this application, from this React application to this React application. Okay. And even if I go, if I then 10, okay, I'm an Angular, then the dynamically if the King is 10, who are, so what it is seeing, right? So when I remove it, it goes up. So what you are seeing is dynamic rendering of frameworks. So in a single application, I'm rendering React, View and Angular. So what the advantage is it? So people are says it's very easy to learn a framework, a frontend framework. Yeah, it's very easy to learn a frontend framework, but it's very hard to master it. So you have a team of people who is very good in Angular. So there is another team of people who is very good in React. There's another team of people who loves Vue and they are very good in Vue. So we should not force them to change the UI frameworks, right? So what we have the future called micro frontend. So that team can work separately. So that the team which loves React, our team which loves Angular, our team which loves Vue can work separately. Can they able to work separately and they can able to push a code to the report. So the product workflow will go straight without any compromise. So I just have a POC of this. So what I done, just I show what I done. So there is no magic in it. So first we see the source. So if you see the source, King is a React bundle, Kong is a React bundle, Vue.js is a V bundle. So I have four source, and if I, you know, if I, so this dynamically I'm fetching from the from the server side. See, I know I'll show how I done. If I go to the network, okay, sorry. See, I'm fetching the Angular bundle from the from my server. So that's how it works. So what I does, there is no magic actually in it. It's all just a div rendering. We need to give the respective div so that it will render there. So if I go and see my distribution, if I go and see index.dml, I'm just giving my bundle like King, Kong, Vue, nothing more. So this bundle gonna have the King, which is a React app, and Kong is a React app, and Vue.js is a React app, and Angular is an Angular application. So I have the source King, Kong, Server, Vue. Sorry, King, Kong, Angular, Vue. So I'm doing it by Webpack. So Webpack actually does it work. So I'm using a Webpack bundling. So I'm giving the port. King, Kong, and Vue, and Angular. So Webpack dynamically, you know, bundle the which actually transpiles the EX6 code to ES5, and which bundles the library and actually populate here. That's how it works. So Webpack, we're using Webpack, and we use a lot of bundling tool available in online, but Webpack is a pretty famous and it's very mature. So that's why I'm using Webpack, and I'm also very good. I'm expert in Webpack. That's also another reason. So by using Webpack, I go to this my source and King Kong view and Angular. I'm actually bundled here. So next, how to communicate with each other? So how can I communicate with React application to the King React application to Kong React application? That is a thing called dog custom event. So custom event comes under WP WTC consortium. So with custom event, this custom is a global event. It's not this event is not specific to particular application. It's a global event. So I'm getting an event here. I'm getting acknowledged king event here, the details. And so whenever I plus, whenever I click plus button, whenever I click the plus button, even I click this addition button. So I'm actually dispatching an event, custom event, which is actually listened by all the applications in all the frameworks in the application. So if I go to Kong, you see, right, I have document.rListener in the constructor, so that it listened to acknowledge Kong listen, Kong event. So when the event triggered by King, it will listen here. So automatically based on the event listener, I'm passing the value to right. I'm changing the value in here. So if I press, you can see, right? If I press here, it's value changing. That's how it works. See, 1, 2, so it's how it works. So so how come I actually rendered the Angular framework? Because dynamic rendering, dynamic pulling of library is very 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 dangerous, and it need to re-render the application too. So what it does, that comes ecstasy. So that comes the idea. So what how I'm doing it, right? I'm just doing it. If you go to King, if you come down, okay. I'm just handle JS load. So whenever I click right, whenever I just reach a value stage, it pops that number. So if the value is 10, so if the value is 10, right? If the King value is 10. So what I'm doing, right? I'm just creating an element by myself. Create element. So I'm just pulling the library from the cloud, pulling the library from a server, and rendering it on load by using React. That's how it works. So there won't be any errors occur, right? So it works accordingly based on the value, because I'm pulling the AngularJS bundle when I need it, not every time. So and also after pulling the library only and rendering the application, so it works. Eventually, that's a cool step. So that's my site. So that's how I given the idea. So first is I'm communicating using custom event to the frameworks, and second is I'm just dynamically pulling the Angular library on render time, on the render time, so that it actually render the Angular application. So it's all this purpose. So even you can use server side rendering too. There's something called the React re-edit. So that it actually helps. It actually helps you to create a server-side rendering too. So that's what. Even you can do server-side rendering to render the frameworks, different frameworks in a single application. So that's my POC. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.